So far, you've learned that PCA represents your data in a new orthonormal basis that you can find from the eigenvectors of the covariance matrix. That means that once we have the scores and the weights, we should be able to reconstruct X by projecting back into the standard basis. To do this, we'll multiply both sides of this equation by W transpose. And let's think a bit about what this WW transpose on the right is going to return. So if you think about the off diagonals of this matrix, that'll be the dot product of basis vector I and basis vector J. And that's going to give you a zero because they're orthogonal. And on the diagonals, that's the dot product between basis vector I and itself. That's going to be one because they're normalized. So that means that this WW transpose is the identity matrix, so you can just remove this. And it really is just that simple, that to reconstruct X, you just need to multiply the scores by the transpose of the weight matrix. And importantly, don't forget to add the mean that you had originally removed when doing PCA. Okay, but you might be thinking, hang on, the whole point of doing PCA was to reduce the dimensionality. So can you reconstruct the data using the low dimensional representation that you have built? And you can do this by truncating the scores in the weight matrix after the top k components, multiplying them, and again adding the mean, and that gives you some estimate for the original data, and I'm going to call that estimate x hat. And you might want to know, how does that estimate compare to the best possible estimate that we could find based on a k-dimensional basis? And it turns out that if you do that optimization problem, you again find the eigenvectors of the covariance matrix. So it turns out that PCA has two equivalent formulations, either minimizing the reconstruction error or maximizing the projected variance, and that's actually pretty cool. Okay, so in the next exercise, you're going to use your low dimensional representation to reconstruct the MNIST dataset.